Hello, I'm David Hunt, and welcome to Staying Alive. It's a panel show about the power people. Yes, the grey power I'm talking about. Let's introduce our panel for today. We've got Lisa up the end. Hello, Lisa.
Hi, David. How are you?
I'm well. Fantastic. And we've got Gordon next to me. Hello, Gordon.
Hi, David. Hi, Lisa.
And we've got the gorgeous Greg sitting next to
David,
me.
David, thank you.
Hello.
Thank you.
G'day, Greg. Our topic today is legacy. It's never too late to make a difference. And I think it's really important that we all leave a little bit of a legacy behind when we go. And it's the sort of thing that you almost have to do sooner than later, because you never know when your time's going to be up. There's a bus waiting out there for you to knock you over one day.
Don't look at me like that.
Don't look at you. So, Gordon, what do you think is your legacy? Have you left anything behind, or is there something you would like to do?
Well, I'm an artist, of course, so that some of my artwork will stay on.
Right, okay. Now, but how are people going to see that? Have you got a Facebook page?
No, I don't.
Why not?
Because you keep telling me to have one and I haven't got one.
But don't you think it's working.
Actually, Vintage Men are going to put up a Facebook as well, so I might put some of my stuff on Vintage Men.
Right.
But also, I think the legacy that I will leave is the fact that I've worked for so long in the community doing different bits and pieces. I think people will remember me for that.
Tell us some of the things you do.
Oh, 21 years with the VAC as a volunteer. Mm-hmm. I'm the secretary treasurer of Vintage Men. I'm the secretary treasurer of the Malvern Artist Society, and I'm a presenter on Joy. I think that's enough.
I think you've overachieved. And so the one legacy that you'd like to be leaving behind, is it your art?
Oh, and the people that know me, that'll be my legacy, I think.
A good point. Lisa?
I haven't even thought about that, to be quite honest. I being in my mid-40s, I kind of don't know, perhaps I haven't even thought about leaving anything behind. I certainly don't have children, so that's not something that I can do. But I do volunteer at Joy, obviously. I've got about 3 different positions at Joy. So if anything, I think I'm contributing to the GLBTI community, so I feel like I'm making a contribution there.
I'm going to correct you there, because you have started leaving a legacy.
You'll
know straight away when I say, On your radio show on Friday night, something extra special happened. Was it 2 weeks ago?
Two weeks ago, yeah.
Tell us.
I had an email from an Indian person, and they're struggling over there at the moment with the change of the legislation. So basically it's sort of illegal for them to be show any sort of affection or homosexual behaviour over there. So
they've reversed it.
They've reversed the 377,
yep.
Basically. And I felt so inspired by them, and I decided to do a show 2 weeks ago, basically campaigning in 377. And it was just supposed to be just check out their website, whatever. There was about 6,000 people tuned in, and I think that was astounding. And I was kind of very taken aback and very humbled by that. So I'm one of their Australian ambassadors at the moment.
Yeah, and they were actually, a lot of them were collected together in a room, and
yes.
They were crying,
yes.
Weren't they? Because
that someone was actually listening to them, and I find the plight of other countries and what they have to go to, we're very lucky here in Australia. So that,
You're starting your legacy. Yeah. Now, Greg, you're a bit of an overachiever.
Well, sometimes in my own lunchtime.
In your own lunchtime.
That's right. Well, for me, it's probably, if you go to Ringwood and you go to the Cadbury's factory on the side of the Cadbury's storage factory is my name on a plaque.
What
a great little legacy that is.
Why?
And there's some park
ate
with
the most chocolate.
No, I was the mayor at the time. So on a boulder in a playground. Right next to a public toilet is my name and another plaque.
Right.
Right next to the local beat.
That'd be right.
But I suppose with Jane from Joy as well.
And Ben TV.
Being part of 5,000 police, training 5,000 brand new police officers in the last 5 years into community culture about respect for our LGBTIQ communities. I think that's a bit of a legacy I've left behind.
Now, with that, you actually go to the cadets and you have one-on-ones with them, is that right?
We have speed dating.
Right.
We've had speed dating with 5,000 police cadets and
nice.
Recruits, as police and PSO recruits. And they get to unpack our culture, who we are, what makes us up, where we've come to. Our legacy, they actually discover why we feel we do with the police as we do.
Right.
And they go into their working lives being informed by that. So it's a really valuable thing, especially when a PSO or a police member comes up to you and says, I spoke to you. 4 months ago or 2 years ago at the academy.
And it made some
It's changed my life, my difference. Professional life.
Yeah. And with a lot of those cadets, they would be brought up in a household where they wouldn't know any gay people.
Exactly right.
And so therefore it is really important to actually have that contact with you, especially because they're going to come across it in their field.
Well, amongst them, one of them will be a police commissioner one day. They'll be the head of the police force, and they would have come through this partnership with our community along the way. That's the legacy.
And I feel that us doing this show is a legacy as well, because it will be documented and it will be there in the archive somewhere in 20, 30 years' time, where people will actually hear us talking about our aging population as a reference point.
And the point is that with our aging population now, we're going through what they won't have to go through. Because by then we'll have changed everything for the aging population and the LGBTIQ community as a thing. Because, when I was at that conference a couple of weeks ago, it was that was very interesting about the aging process of our community, and it's going to happen. You know, that it'll be much better, and the next generation coming along are going to find it much easier.
And the wonderful legacy of starting Joy, starting Bent TV, and we're being part of it, because sitting here and doing stuff on Joy as well.
I actually have an audio tape of you, David, that I collected over my time at Joy, 12 years at Joy, and I'm going to make sure that's available for Bent TV viewers as well.
David Hunt. Thanks, Greg. Yeah. You're wonderful. And thanks for coming on the show, and I'm sure you won't be on this show ever again. So thanks for being on the show today. Lisa, thank you.
No worries,
for being on the show.
No worries.
And what you're doing with those people in India is magical. Gordon, you're a real overachiever in this respect, and I admire you so much for what you're doing. It's wonderful. So legacy, look at it and do something for your future generations. I'm David Hunt. You've been watching Bent TV, and we'll see you soon.